Hi, in this video we will explore another report of Jira software, which is control chart. And this control chart report is super useful for the kanban type projects. So in this video I'll explain what is control chart, how to access the control chart in Jira instance, and how to read the control chart. First of all, we will see what is control chart. So control chart shows the cycle time for your product, version or sprint. It takes the time spent by each issue in a particular status and maps it over a specified period of time. And it also helps you identify whether data from the current sprint can be used to determine future performance. The less variations in the cycle time of an issue, the higher the confidence in using the median as an indication of future performance. Control chart also helps you to analyze your team's past performance in a retrospective meeting. And for the Kanban type projects, we can use the past performance to set the targets for your team. It also helps you to measure the effect of a process change on your team's productivity, and it provides external stakeholders with the visibility of your team's performance. So these type of benefits we can take from the control chart report. Now we'll see how the control chart looks like. So it is looks like this. So this is a sample control chart, and this image source is from the Atlassian official website. Right now this is just sample, but in the next slide we will go to the Jira instance and we will see how can we access this control chart report in the Jira cloud and how can we read that, and we will discuss some important terms which is very useful to read the control chart. So now we will go to our Jira cloud instance and see how can we access this report. This is my Jira cloud instance and I'll use a sample scrum project here. I'll click and I'll access the report from the reports options in the left side menu. When I click, then here I am and I can see we have the three sections of the reports. First one is Agile, where you can find all the reports related to the Agile. Second one is the issue analysis. And the third one is forecast and the management. But right now, in this video, we will talk about the control chart and which will come under the Agile section. So this is a control chart and here you can see we have a little bit description about it. When I'll click on the control chart, it will take me this page, and this is a control chart report page. There are the three sections here. First one is, it is telling you the guideline how to read this chart. You can see in the left hand side. If you want to hide this information, then you can simply click here and this particular section will be hidden. And here we have the some information about the visibility, efficiency and the predictability. You can read for your understanding. And as just I told you in my previous videos, we have the options to share this report and we have the options to, you know, hide the menus and the any other options. Now we'll come into this sections. Here we have the chart in the x-axis, we have the date, and the y-axis we have the time. And here we have some informations which will help you to read the chart. Like this single green circle will show the issues. It will represent the cluster of issues, and this shaded blue area will represent the standard deviations. So when we will come to this chart, then this particular red line will represent the average time, and this blue line will represent the rolling average time, and this shaded blue area will represent the standard deviations. Okay, when I'll come to this sections, then here we have the three things: time scale, refine report and the viewing options. In the time scales, you can choose your time frame. Right now I'm choosing all time. You can choose a past week, past 2 weeks, month, 3 months or 6 months as per your requirement, or you can choose the custom dates as well. And in the refine report, you can select the column and you can select the quick filters. And in the viewing options, we have to include the non-working days in the calculation or not. If you want to include the non-working days in the calculation, then you can simply check this checkbox and it will add this. You can see the differences in the graph. When I will click, then it will look like this. And if I will uncheck it, then it will look like this. Now we will come to the control chart. So before understanding the control chart, few terms are very necessary to understand. Just like what is cycle time, what is lead time, what is the meaning of the rolling average, and what is the standard deviation. So these are the terms which is very necessary to understand before reading the control chart. So what is cycle time and what is lead time? So cycle time is a time spent working on an issue, typically the time taken from when work begins on an issue to when work is completed. And the lead time is just similar to cycle time, but is the time taken from when an issue is logged, means not when work begins, but it's logged until work is completed on that issue. So this is a lead time. This is a difference between a cycle time and lead time, and it is very important to understand the lead time and the cycle time before reading this control chart. Now we will talk about this gray shaded area, which is called standard deviations. The blue shaded area of the control chart, which is represent the standard deviations, it is the amount of variations of the actual data from the rolling average. The standard deviations gives you an indication of the level of confidence that you can have in the data. If the blue shaded area of your graph is narrow, it means you are on track, you have a less cycle time, and you are more confident to complete the issues on time. But if the standard deviations is not narrow and it's a wide, it means there is something a bottleneck, you need to figure out that. So these are the basic things which will help you to read the control chart, and when you will scroll up and you will see these visibility, efficiency and productivity, it will clearly tell you what is it meaning. So see outlier and investigate their cause to reduce them in the future. And if you will come into the efficiency, then decreasing rolling average indicate process improvements and increased throughput. And if you will come to this predictability, then narrow standard deviations that I told you recently in this video, through process improvements to improve predictability of the cycle time. I hope now you can read the control chart and you are completely able to find out your bottlenecks and you can check you are on track or not. If you have any question related to the control chart, then please feel free to ask into the comment box and definitely I'll help you. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.